this announcement.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah, what is it?
I notice you're packing a Winchester.
Sure, I'll pack it. Why not? It's mine.
You always pack a Winchester?
You're damn right.
Why is that, ma'am?
Well, you know, I remember my uncle always used this here rifle. Said it never let him down.
What do you expect from a modern gun?
When I pull the trigger, I expect it to pump out a slug.
Would you pack another brand?
No, mister.
You sure of that?
I'm quite sure.
Well, I'd like to put it to a test, ma'am. I offer you two of these in place of your Winchester.
No.
I'll give you these two new guns for your old one.
No.
Try looking at it from the economic angle. Two of these guns for one.
I already told you, I'm not interested. Why would I change a gun that's never let me down?
Well, I think you're joking. Now, ma'am, I'll take
your
Winchester.
No.
Folks, you see, no one accepts my offer because of Winchester. It can finish you off faster, can protect you better. And the price is right.
Remember, folks, June the 4th is the Bobby Dancer's Day. See you later.
Go back to work. Minnesota clay, I caught a month ago. MacGregor, now there is a son of a... But for him, I'll wait. His reward will go up soon. Let's have a look at the prices on Bounty Street. Chuck Mortimer down 20%, James Brothers down 10%, Jeremy Bronx down 5%. This is a depressed market. Anti-inflation measures are called for. If the index falls below this so far all-time low, don't fret or run away. Providenza is on his way. Let's get the latest news. Fantastic. Galveston, re-Hurricane Kid. Trial of this famous bandit captured by Providenza opens today.
So long?
Yes, master.
Head for Galveston.
Yes, sir.
Yeah?
There's no water in the tank!
Waiter? Water, please.
Water.
Water. No, not a glass, a barrel of water.
Listen, my place, I only sell whiskey cheap. Water will cost you, mister. That barrel's $100.
Hey, stranger, want to have a little bet with me? Give you a chance to win that $100?
What do I have to do?
Just try and do everything I do.
The barrel. Thank you.
But I'll be.
Are you Julius P. Hatchengravis? alias Hurricane Kid? You're hereby charged with the following. Armed robbery of the bank in Yuma. Setting fire to Fort Worth. Hitting an officer of the law with a bottle. Rustling in Tucson. Using a pornographic branding iron. Holding up the Denver stage. Destruction of a saloon in Sacramento. Illegal entry and burglary of the Fresno Gambling Hall. Robbery of pocketbook, watch, and Bible of Reverend Ted Emerson. Theft and killing of two sheep belonging to Andrew Warren, rancher. Damage to public property in the destruction of the town horse trough while using it for purposes it was not created for. Theft of a complete dinner from Sam Barrett's eating house. Court from the sheriff's wife while he was out of town investigating rancher Warren's missing sheep. 8 counts of assault and battery while resisting a lynching party. Receiving stolen property. 250 head of cattle stolen on the trail while being herded to the rock with the service's rescue. Attempted bribery of a public official. Theft of a clean dinner from a suspicious eating house. Along with two bottles of bourbon. Derailment of a train and theft of 20 mail bags. Breaking and entering the Lake Martin Bank in Nebraska. The use of indecent and suggestive language in the mayor's Salt Lake City contributing to the lady's moral corruption in the seduction of the false. crimes than you have already committed, and all the many other crimes you undoubtedly would commit, I do sentence you, Julius P. Hatchin Rabbit, alias Hurricane Kid, to 140 years, 6 months, and 32 days.
No, I am sorry, Your Honor, I object. I object absolutely. As an honest and upright citizen, I object. This man is a dangerous fiend. Why should he be sheltered and fed by a citizen for, let's say, about the next 6 or 7 years?
You watch what you're saying.
Silence in the courtroom.
I, Providenza, saint of all good men, voted the best in the West, condemn Hurricane Kid to be taken away and hanged by the neck until dead. May God have mercy on his soul.
Come on.
No! Hey,
no! Let me go! No! No!
Come on, Fatso, get up. We should go.
I'm gonna kill you. Why'd you have me sentenced to death?
How else could I have saved you?
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Let's go.
I can't figure it out, Providenza. First you saved me from the gallows, and now you keep me locked up. Why?
Why? Well, because you remind me of something I loved when I was a child.
I do? What's that?
A money box shaped like a pig.
Me?
Just a metaphor. You escaped from the gallows, and now you're worth much more.
You mean I'm screwed again?
Mm-hmm. Corn that pops. Corn that pops. Pretty tasty. I flood the world with it. I call it popcorn. Taste it.
Yeah, well, it won't sell.
Oh, the latest news. President Grant has died. Rutherford Hayes has taken his place. The new president has declared a general
amnesty. Ah, that means I'm pardoned. That means I'm free. I'm a free man. I'm a free man. I've been pardoned by the president. Oh, come on, Providenza. Don't be sad. You've been working too hard. No more of this rat race for you. No more. You can take... No more bandits, no more rewards, no more of that wanted stuff. You can relax and take the sun, the both of us can. We can relax because I'm free. Hey, Providenza, we should be celebrating because I'm free. Dum-dum-dum. Thank you.
Shut up, mister.
What did you say?
Shut up, you idiot.
What did you say?
Big ugly slob.
You shouldn't talk to me like that.
No,
hey!
I didn't mean it.
Good time, Providencer?
No.
Oh, come on, Providencer. I don't like to see you like this. After all, I'm your buddy.
You're my what?
I'm your buddy.
I'm your master.
Hey, I got an idea. Why don't we go ahead and...
Don't be pathetic, Hurricane. You can't have ideas. You have an empty head.
Oh, yeah? Look, I've got a trade and you're out of work. So why don't we stick together and pull some nice holdups and robberies, huh? You know, the brains and the brawn.
Because it is not my style, you idiot.
It's mine. Your big toe's got more brains than my head.
Besides, my job is to deliver criminals.
You mean it used to be.
Listen, you obviously don't know about the theories of Prather and Libet. According to them, the criminal will always return to his victim. The only thing I have to do is wait.
What are you going to do in the meantime?
I'll take a long weekend. Friday to Monday.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, look!
Help! Luscious lady, don't dismay! Providence is on his way!
Help! Help! What's your name?
Providenza. For you, Provi. And you?
Pamela Cervantes Ribeira Preziosa, of Italian ancestry. For you, Pam. At my college in Virginia, I studied Latin and Greek too, classical dance and music. Then I returned home at 16, to our mansion in Wisconsin. It was nice to be home, but I soon became very unhappy and depressed. The medical specialist there told me I should get some sea air. And that's how we met, Pravi. Oh, I'm sorry, how rude. All I've done is simply talk about myself, and you've said nothing. Who are you? Providenza.
All right, I'll sing you a song. In Italian.
Listen to me now. Un segreto ti dirò. Quella domenica il signor non riposò. No. Ma lavoro, mischio insieme l'astuzia, la simpatia, l'intelligenza, la bellezza, e chi creò?
Provi, provi,
provi,
provvidenza, 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 provi, provi,
that's provi. Thank you, girls. That's beautiful.
Può parlare coi bantu, bananina guadababadu, enciclopedico, ne sa più di Belzebù, e i maghi indù, yeah. E sa tirare di scherma e giocare, senza cavalli, va in diligenza, è lui chi è?
Provi, provi, provvidenza,
è lui,
provvidenza,
provi,
provvidenza, provi, provi,
provvidenza,
provvidenza, provvidenza,
that's it, everybody together,
provvidenza, provvidenza, provvidenza.
That's it! Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, Bravi. Dad will be so happy to meet you. Thursday, there'll be a party at our Wisconsin mansion.
All right, nobody move. This is a holdup. Sit tight and you won't get hurt.
Something,
I'll
stop it,
Ferdinand.
Something.
That's
a real brave one.
Oh, April Fool! Hurricane Kid.
How did you recognize me, Providenza?
Simple, from the smell. Now, be a good boy and give everything back, kid.
Don't fool with me, Providenza. You better stay away from me or I'll shoot. Now help me, I'll shoot. I'll shoot.
Go ahead. Shoot.
Hey, that was pretty clever. Let's see if you can do it again.
Okay. I'll be back, my love. Get out! 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 Out!
My love.
Hey, whoa, it's a train without a track. Come on, let's go have a look.
gentlemen, the suit you now see being worn by Berenenza is a raiders from Rome, an Indian silk, two-piece in Vatican off-white. It has one button fixing, and as you can see, it comes with matching hat, bag, umbrella, shirt, tie, and gloves. Jacket and pants are lined with top-quality nylon, and gloves are made from the skin of the little white rhinoceros. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Ay, 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 ay.
Mon amour.
Nice to see you. Oh, I'd like you to meet Baron Manfred von Richthofen.
Oh, the famous Red Baron, Sir Rangen Herr Graf. Oh, but the boy, Snoopy says hello, sir.
Would you like something to drink?
Whatever you want. Por el nuestro amor. Magnifique. Cordelin Bleu, Grand Reserve, 14 degrees, and bottled by the great Jean Lepluy in April 1861.
I'm sorry to have to contradict you, sir. April 1863.
April 1861. The Reserve of 63 was nearly all thrown into the Indian Ocean by Count de Cordelin because he found a lot of bodies in the wine.
Bodies good, sir.
Body in wine is good in the singular, but not in the plural. Mon amour, ton père.
Daddy? Oh, yes, come on, he's inside.
No. No more time, I'm sorry, sir. Accept my terms or I'll have to prosecute.
Daddy?
But don't you...
Good evening, Daddy. Good evening, Captain Bart.
It's a pleasure to see you again, Pamela.
Oh, Daddy, this is Providenza, the man I spoke to you about.
It's a great pleasure, sir.
An even greater one for me, monsieur. Haven't we met before in Panama?
No, I've never been there.
At any rate, Count, I would like to ask you for the hand of the beautiful Pamela.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. You arrived a little too late. I have just given my daughter's hand to Captain Bart.
Oh, Daddy, without even asking me.
I was forced to.
Count, according to Mandel's theory, it is practically impossible to match a rose with a cabbage.
Who are you calling a cabbage, huh?
Inasmuch as the Count is a strong oak, and I am a fresh lily, you are the cabbage!
You'll pay for that. On guard. Defend yourself.
Look, spider. Terribly unattractive, Captain Cabbage.
On guard!
Outrageous. Now I have to change.
Thank you.
Look! Up there! Oh. Up there! Oh. No!
Not bad, Providenza. You remember Zorro's lessons, eh?
Count, I'll ask you again for the hand of your daughter, Pamela.
It is impossible, sir. In a moment of difficulty, I was obliged to borrow $500,000 from Captain Bart. I have to cover the debt at the end of the week. With one of two things, the money or Pamela.
The money you shall have, sir.
Trinity, how many times must I tell you? You must wash your hands before a meal.
Good morning, sister.
Good morning. Where was I? Oh, yeah, Wyatt. He said to me, you take the guy on the left. So I did. And Wyatt, he danced with the other one.
I have a deal to offer you.
I've changed my mind. I will be partners with you.
For how long?
For a week.
What do I get out of this partnership?
I'll give you a piece of the take.
A piece? A piece is not enough. I want two pieces.
What about 2%?
Yeah. In that case, I'd rather go back to the rest home.
Kid, 2% of $500,000 is $10,000.
Okay, I'm with you. Where do we pull this job?
Right here.
Where do you think you're going, you idiot? Do what I say, hmm? Tomorrow you'll come here dressed like a real gentleman and out of towner.
Get your bets down, gents. That's it. Number four, yes, sir. Bets down. Bets down. Yes, sir. Here we go, gents.
On seven.
You got it. Lucky seven. No more bets. Round and round she goes.
Round and round. Come on. Come on, seven.
Where she stops, nobody knows.
Come on, seven. Come on, seven.
The winner is seven. Black on even.
I bet it. I had number seven. I bet the seven. Give me the money. Give me the money.
All right, gents, get your pants down.
How do you like that? And I never played. Hey, look, I won. I won. Hey, just put it. That's it. All right, put the money right over here. That's a good fella.
Get your bets down, gents. That's it. What's that?
17.
What about
17?
What's that? Oh,
18.
What about 18? Get your bets down, gents. Get your bets down. Red.
Oh,
red.
I can tell this is
going to
be my lucky night tonight.
Down.
Yes, sir.
Down. All right, gentlemen, that's
five.
The last call.
I bet all of it on five.
It's your dough.
The whole
here
thing.
We go. No more.
You got that? Five. Come on, five. Five. Come on, five. Come on.
The winner is...
I did it! I won twice in a row! I did number five! I told you it was going to be my lucky night, didn't I? Boy, tonight really is my night, ain't it?
Hey, gentlemen. You're lucky tonight, sir. It's your lucky night. Are you going to let it ride on five, sir?
Right. Oh, yeah. 21. Yeah, 21. I bet it all on 21, the whole thing.
21, yes, sir. All right, no more bets.
21, just drop in there. Just drop in there.
Yeah,
I just know it's going to be 21.
21.
I did it again. Three times a row. I 21 three times in a row. Give me the money.
Where's the money? Here you are, sir.
Oh, look at that. Have you ever seen so much money?
All right, gents, there's a new game. Put your money down. Get your best
14.
Down.
I bet it all on 14.
14, the gentleman marks.
14. Come on. Come on, 14. 14, come on. Come on, 14.
The winner is 14.
I won again. Four times I win. Give me my money.
Seeing as to how you bet on 32, you didn't win.
Oh, no. I bet on 32.
Yeah, you bet on 32. I saw it quite clearly. Your money was on 32.
Ain't that right?
That's right. I saw it, too. 32 was it.
Oh, no. I bet on number 14. You saw me. Everyone at this table saw me. I bet on number 14. You know I did. Well, I didn't bet on any 32, I'll tell you. 32. I win again. Give me the money. Pay me. Oh. I broke the game. Here, have a drink on me.
Seems a pity to leave so early, sir. Why not try your hand at the crap table?
Why not? Tonight I'm lucky. We'll do it.
No. It is not possible. You're very tired, and you have to go.
No. I'm not tired. I'm not asleep.
He wants to play a little craps.
I'm terribly sorry. I'd like to speak to my friend a minute. Come here.
Excuse me.
Listen. You're going to lose everything, Martin.
No, I won't, Providence. You go on home. Tonight I'm lucky. Did you see how that ball kept jumping over into the numbers?
Of course.
I'll bankrupt that crap table.
Why don't you mind your own business, friend?
That's exactly what I am doing, sir. Oh. Yes, indeed. Please sit down. But au revoir, santé, monsieur.
You guys, get after him.
Halt!
Ha ha ha.
Okay, kid. Let's go.
No. I told you I wanted to gamble.
When I say let's go, it means let's go.
Lost your shirt, kid?
I'll never play craps again, Providence. How come I was doing so well, and then all of a sudden, I lost...
Oh, never mind. Now we have to make a new deal. We rob a bank to get the $500,000.
Sure, that's nice. Another bank, I'd like that. You've forgiven me. We're still partners, huh, Providence?
Yes, but now I give you 1%.
1%? Mm-hmm.
Yes, sir.
Oh, sure. That's right. Thanks, Providence, sir.
Oh, don't move. Got it. That's what you get for hitting me.
Doesn't look like me.
Hello, sir! Sir!
Do you read me?
Loud and clear, over.
There's a spy out here, sir.
Where's the spy? I'll get the spy.
I need a flashing red light.
No. It's just that the oil is finishing. We have to stop and buy some.
All right, yes, sir.
Here's a crackpot again. You want water, hmm? You want another barrel of water, right?
No, I don't want water. I want some oil.
Ah, well, that's a pity, sir. The price of water's way down. I'm afraid oil's gonna cost you. This barrel goes for $100.
Hey, how about another little bet with me? For $100?
Okie doke.
Now I'll release this fly, shoot off both his wings. Think you can do that too?
From the noise, I assume it's a male fly. He's not a male fly anymore. Brawley? Burrell, lights off. Thank you very much, sir.
Just a moment. Please, wait a moment. Please, I beg of you, wait a moment. In the name of Santa Rosalia, take me to Wichita. I'll give you $100. I've got to get there fast.
Please tell Santa Rosalia we're terribly sorry, but we're going that way.
But it's the emergency. It's for Don Vito Ascalone.
The Godfather?
Yes. Please, why don't you take me to Wichita immediately, sir? I must bring to Don Vito a doctor.
Say no more. Your troubles are over. I am a doctor.
A real doctor?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Rosalia.
What's wrong with him?
He got a bad lead poisoning during a family feud. It happened this morning while he was in town at the fruit store. And they
hey,
blasted
wait
the
for me!
Came out.
Let us go.
Horn.
Glove.
Gloves for you.
Cotton.
Here.
Alcohol.
Alcohol.
Pieces.
There's. Oh, run.
You must behave like a man of honor, Don Vito. Calibers 38.
Good. I'm indebted to you. A great weight has been removed. Oh, say it.
He's thirsty.
Thirsty.
Whenever you're thirsty and want to feel better, try a very good, delicious Italian wine. It's better than milk. You can have it on cornflakes, too.
Grazie.
Don Vito. Salute. It's nothing important. He'll heal very soon. I adore Chinese food. Delicious, delicious.
What is it? 100-year-old eggs?
No. White worms stuffed with red ants covered with a grasshopper sauce.
You want a drink, sir?
Yes, thank you. A touch of DDT, please.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Very good.
Well, that did it. That did it. I'm gonna go to sleep.
You are not going anywhere. We are going to rob a bank.
Tonight?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Where are we headed?
To Tucson.
Tucson? Ain't no bank in Tucson.
That's right.
Finally built a town bank. What do you know? Look!
Henry, look!
There we are. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Next, please. Thank you, sir. $1,500. Fingerprint, sir. Right here, sir. Next, please. Good morning, sir. Oh, that's beautiful. Beautiful. Let me see. 21 inches of money. 21 inches by 7.2 minus 0.3 for waste makes exactly $2,800, sir. Thank you very much. Your signature. Thank you. Right there. Good money, sir. Next, please.
$20. It's all I've saved, Mr. Banker.
This lady,
first lady client of the Providence Banking Company has won $100.
There you are.
$100. Very good. Good luck. Good luck, lady. Good luck. Next, please.
Good morning, sir. Wow.
Caliber 35.
You wouldn't give me my money.
Well?
£4.03. £4.03 multiplied by 2 ounces gives us $1,350.
Thank you very much. Your signature here.
Thank you very much. Next, please. Oh, sorry. Close for the day. Terribly sorry, ladies and gentlemen. Tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock.
Hey, Providenza, why are we closing? We were doing so well.
Don't be greedy, kiddo. We already have $500,000.
All right, you two, drop those bags.
Help! Please! Help! Help!
Come on, move on.
Help! Please! Get him! Get him!
Help. No trick!
Get him! Get him!
Ah, no. You're not using that to marry her.
Hop, two, three, hop, two, three, one, two, three, hop.
Come on.
You got any ideas?
None at all. When I read my horoscope this morning, and it said to exercise, to be happy, to have faith in the future, and I will have a very nice encounter.
Size and color, I would say they belong to the Blackfeet Indian tribe.
There ain't no Indians around here.
Very matter-of-factly, look to your left. Oh, pretend I'm a bear, you know. I was telling him what Olga said that night, and he couldn't believe it, you know. He said that Frank had told him a different version of... Sir, can you tell me where Second Avenue is, please?
What are they going to do to us now? Oh? What'd he say?
Cut off our ears and our fingers. Put us onto a pile of wood and burn us to a cinder.
Why?
Money to Ahu.
What'd he say? It hasn't rained in 7 moons. They'll burn us for the god Money to.
But why? Well, why us?
Inga, 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 oh, money too, Inga.
You like it, huh?
Oh.
Hey, how'd you do it, Providence?
Quite simple. I saw that some humid air was just messing 2 or 3 degrees northwest, while some warm air was coming from the south, and I knew it would obviously create a turbulence that would result in heavy precipitation.
How'd you find that out?
Through my herpes-sensitive index finger. That's why it is always uncovered.
You have won Oscar for best supporting rainmaker in whole west. Ungerwug.
Congratulations, Providence.
Grazie, gran capo, cacio cavallo. Ora mi do che c'è l'intervallo. Aranciate, caramelle, bruscolini, mostaccioli gelati.
You are the moonlight, palm of my life, palm of my life. I love you, palm. I love you, palm.
Those Indians are kind of stingy with their gratitude.
Well, we have something better than gratitude. We have money.
Where'd you hide the loot? You're not going to jip me again.
Well, we don't have it yet, but it's like we have it.
What do you mean?
Well, the chief Comanche told me a very, very precious secret. On Tuesdays, the Sacramento Yuma Topeka train just happens to carry $500,000.
Hey! We're going to hold up a train?
No, we're going to buy 2 bags.
No kid, why?
Why? To put the money in.
Well, if we don't have the money, what are we going to buy the bags for?
Patient, Pato.
Well, look who's here.
What'll it be, mister? Barrel of water?
No.
Oil, then?
No. I want a pair of bags, a black one and a white one, at $50 each.
Yeah. I'll get them for you.
Thank you.
Just keep on coming back, don't you, little fella? Would you like to try another little bet with me again?
For $100.
Tell me a card.
The King of Hearts.
You want to try it now?
Pick out my card.
Ace of clubs, okay?
Throw them up, sir. You'd better look after your money now that you have a pawn with the leak. Raleigh? And bags.
Lights off.
Thank you very much, sir.
I want to ship these 2 suitcases to Sacramento in the mail train.
It'll be a pleasure. We're all back at work, eh? So the mail will be going through.
Yeah. These 2 suitcases are very valuable, see? They're full of diamonds.
Oh, well, don't worry about a thing. I'll put them in the special bullion car with the gold nuggets that are going today. They'll travel with the guard all the way to Sacramento. Guaranteed.
Yeah, guaranteed.
Okay, so long. Get the steam up. We gotta be in Sacramento by tomorrow morning.
Why?
No thanks, I don't smoke.
Providenza.
Lie to us, kid. I'll put a bullet in you.
You'll find him in the black one. I told you the truth. Let me get one thing straight. You promised not to hurt him, remember?
Don't worry about a thing. You have my word. He'll be all right. Tickets for two bags.
Right.
You listening, Providenza? You've come to the end of the road, amigo.
Hey, you can't do that. My friend's inside there. That'd be murder.
Yeah, that's right. What's the matter, though?
Come on, you promised me.
Oh, I never keep my promises.
Oh. You're the worst son of a gun this side of the Mississippi River, and you're a liar.
Yeah, well, there's only one good thing about Providenza. Know what it is?
No.
He's dead now.
What about the gold, Captain?
We'll split it, 80-20.
Sorry to disappoint you, Captain. You won't be able to divide anything with anybody.
Hey, Providenza, you're great. You're a genius. How'd you do it?
It is not elementary, Fatso. It is obvious. A professional never sticks to his original plan.
What the? Well, that's impossible. What to do about smacking your hand or...
I would like to ask the director of this movie if he'd be so kind as to show the folks this masterstroke of ability. Moviola, please.
My pleasure. Let's see that bit of action in slow motion. What happens is that Providenza leans down and picks up the gun too fast for the captain to see. Watch. There we go. Film runs at 24 frames a second, and he picks up the gun in about 12 frames. That's half a second. Let's go back and run it again at normal speed. Now watch closely. In other words, during the time that Captain Bart is trying to pull out his pistol, Providenza has leaned down, picked up his derringer, and is back in position. That's a point against the captain and not against the bowler. Pardon, I meant Providenza. And now back to reality. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you kindly, sir.
I have to admit, Providenza, you're an adversary who deserves to win. Congratulations. Pamela is yours.
Hmm. Oh, thank you very much, sir. Thank
Providenza, you're fantastic. Here, hold this. Yeah, I'm tired.
Can't you guess? We are two prisoners in a fort, standing up against a wall. In front of us, there are a dozen soldiers with guns pointed at us. Idiot, what do you think they're going to do?
Kill us.
You're very clever. But it's much too late. Adieu, Pamela, sweet amour. Adieu, Hurricane Kid, faithful fat friend. Despite all your awful defects, you were a good friend to me.
I don't want to die.
You sound like a woman! Face the music like a man, kid! For the West, for the sake of tradition, and for the motherland!
Crying out loud, Providenza, do something.
Hurricane Kid and Providenza, for physically resisting arrest, for running a fake banking house, and robbing a mail train, you are sentenced by the military to die before this firing squad. Sergeant?
I would like to make one last request.
Fair enough. What do you want?
1 minute.
1 minute, huh? Yeah. 30 seconds will do. go skater, Sergeant.
Let's go.
Take that mask off. I know who you are.
Put it back on, Nutso.
Ben, we look for you everywhere. It's a miracle we're alive, but we managed to cover our tracks.
Huh? Get going, so long!
The case! You have forgotten the case!
Wait a minute! Wait! Wait for me! Hold on, so long! Go on!
Drive flat out, Song!
pani per los muertos. Pani per los muertos. Gold little honey bee. Pani per los muertos. Pani para los muertos.
The engine won't work. It won't work. We cannot move.
Calm.
Now what do we do, Providence?
Calm down, my boys. Calm down.
Calm down.
Calm down.
What are we gonna do now?
When you are in an awkward plight and no rescue is in sight, who's around to save your soul, sir? No one but
Providenza.
You now.
Oh. This is Captain Providence speaking. Please remain calm. The hijacker will be taken care of immediately.
What's that ticket? It's gotta be a bomb, man! Take cover!
You've been hijacked. Now bring this thing down at the prison at Springfield.
Not flopping your arms hard enough. Because of this regrettable incident, we have lost a little time. We have to gain some altitude, so we'll have to get rid of some dead weight. This is Captain Providence calling. Wind velocity, 30 knots. Specific weight, 0.40. We are heading north-northeast. We are flying at an altitude of 1,000 feet. If you look to your left, you can admire the beautiful sight of Wichita. We are hoping to be at Pamela's mansion in 2 hours and 26 minutes. Thank you.
Pam.
Listen, Providenza. I have to talk to you. There's something that's...
Pamela. Go see to your trousseau. You'll have plenty of time to talk tomorrow, after the wedding. Go, I said.
Obey your father.
Oh, yeah. The bag.
Yep.
Count, are you sure we haven't met before?
Have you ever been in Mexico?
Once.
I wasn't there that time.
18 carats. I kept my promise. I hope you keep yours.
Yes, of course. I had a feeling you'd do it. I'll see you tomorrow morning at the church, let's say 10 o'clock.
Pam.
Listen, Bravi. I must tell you the truth. Mm-hmm. That man is not my father.
I'm marrying you, not your father.
He's my husband.
Husband? Now that's a good one.
We're a couple of crooks. We go around the West cheating people. We rent a mansion and go through the Marriage and Promissory Notes Act. That's how we swindled Bart. And then you came into the picture. My husband couldn't believe getting another $500,000. But I can't go through with it, Providenza. I can't. I love you.
I know him. He was the famous bandit. Chankula.
Chankula, yeah. Providencia, you're a smart man. But when you fall in love, you become stupid. You just screwed us out of $500,000. Come on, let's go get our money back. I said, come on!
Chancula!
Realized where I was too late, Providenza.
Oh!
Ah, you're leaving, eh? Running away.
Everything's okay in here.
No. No, 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 no! He threw our gold away! Well, I'm gonna break every bone in your body, you know.
Don't! Stop it! Yeah. Stop it! Don't be a naughty boy. I'm going to give you and Solong the $3,000 reward for Chankula.
Thank you, honorable master. Thank you.
$3,000?
Mm-hmm.
Chankula? What are you gonna do, Providencer?
Everyone in Minnesota says I'm nothing but a joker. And the folks way out in Vegas say my exploits are outrageous. But when they have a lot of trouble, who's their savior? Tell them, girls.